Well, chaos in a Grandview neighborhood after shots ring out. In the aftermath, two teens lay wounded on the frozen streets.
Police shut down several blocks a mile from the high school. And as KMBC 9's Jim Flake reports, they're still investigating exactly what happened.
Call tonight the culmination of a confusing and chaotic day here in Grandview after two teenagers were shot in the minutes after school let out at the high school.
Go to the one on the end.
From News Chopper 9, you could see the full scope of three different crime scenes blocks apart. Seven suspects here, three more taken from this car a few blocks away, shoes and shirt where a victim fell. It all started just after 4 p.m.
We heard about three gunshots.
Becky Simon threw open her door and saw one of the victims fall in the street.
And right up the street, I seen a guy in a red jacket fall to the ground.
You actually saw him fall?
Yeah, I did.
And was he, obviously hurt pretty bad?
Well, he wouldn't get up.
Rick Metzger, a nurse, ran from his home to help out.
He was in stable condition. He just got hit in the back part of his thigh. He got hit up here in the back part of his hip. And then they had another kid that was behind the house that had got away from the scene, and he had got hit in the leg.
Neighbors say it was a fight that started in school.
The guy told him today in school that this was going to happen.
That somebody was going to get shot.
Yes.
Police confirmed that much.
And we're just trying to get to the bottom of what went on. It may have started at the Grandview High School today and carried over, like I said, to the neighborhood.
Beyond that, the confusion remains about what happened, why it happened, and more.
So two teenagers were shot, neither of them shot seriously, that is to say, not life-threatening conditions. Tonight, Grandview police still have a lot on their hands in terms of solving this crime and exactly what happened and who done it. In Grandview, Jim Flink, KMBC 9 News.
Jim, thank you.